All right, guys, I'm headed up to West Palm Beach. We're gonna head offshore, see if we can't get into some mutton snappers. But also, I'm gonna dig into a few products that are on the market that you might find interesting. So stick around.
We're just a few guys that decided to pursue our passion. As we hit destination fishing spots in our local waters out of Pompano Beach, Florida, we wanna fill you in on what we have learned along the way.
So I'm headed up north to West Palm Beach to go meet up with my friends Rick DePaiva and Russ Kleppinger. These are guys that I just know through Johnny Jigs and through the business of fishing. And Rick DePaiva used to run charters, backwater charters on the west coast of Florida. And he's just an avid slow pitch jigger. He has every possible jig you could possibly think of known to man and rod and reel and just loves the sport. He since has retired from running charters and he just fishes for fun, and he's a pilot as well. He flies a private jet airplane. Russ Kleppinger also is a charter boat captain, an active charter boat captain, and he runs inshore as well as offshore charters. And you know, he's the guy you really want to call if you want to go down to Miami or the Keys to go out slow pitch jigging, or if you want to go inshore and catch some tarpon. He's an excellent angler, and when he's not fishing for work, he's fishing for fun, and that's just his passion and what he loves to do. So I pull up to Phil Foster Memorial Park, and it's an island that's in the middle of the intercoastal. So as you go over the bridge, you can make a quick turn and get onto this island, or you can keep going over to the other side of the intercoastal. So I pull into the park and I meet up with Rick, and he's got his brand new Dusky 227 on the trailer ready to launch. And this is the first time I've laid eyes on the boat in its entirety and completion. And he has 34 rod holders around the boat, including 14 of them that are on the console. Basically, every rod that you're gonna bring can go on the console. That way you have freedom to move around the boat while you're fishing, and you don't have things in your way that you're having to shuffle around and move. And just a few other bells and whistles that Rick has dialed into this boat. If you guys don't know him, a lot of people call him Mr. Simrad. And on his boat, he has the NSS Evo 3 with a 12-inch screen. It's the new one with the quad processor, which is nice because if you touch the screen and try to stretch it and zoom in, it's like that. It instantly zooms in and you get a clear picture right away. You're not waiting for this system to load. It's an excellent, excellent system.
Where are we starting out at?
I don't know, there's so many numbers. We're gonna start out at about 145.
145.
Yeah, we're gonna go to the place called the Mutton Hump.
Okay, so I assume you catch groupers there?
Yeah, we got, it's a mutton hump, but yeah. You know what? There's other visitors.
Where there's muttons, there's groupers, right?
That's right, there's other visitors, and we got like four king mackerel yesterday.
Oh, okay.
And none of them got cut off, all of them stayed put.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, it was real fishy yesterday with my report. All muttons.
Yep.
See those muttons?
Muttons!
Write those coordinates down, guys. All mutton snappers right there. So we're getting on our first drop right here. 176, so I'm going with a 200 gram super. And I like this gold and red for muttons and groupers. So that's what I'm putting down. And Ricky DePaiva putting down the flatback, the OG flatback. So that's an older one without the new eye design, but that's a Johnny Jig flatback. And then we got Captain Russ here in the back, and he's gonna fish with a split ring, as you can see.
This is the new and improved split ring. It really works good. The fish don't see it.
It's an invisible split ring, huh?
That's right.
Huh?
Oh!
Got him again? Mark the fish again. Real hard bottom right here. Oh. Solid?
That was a good hit.
There you go, Ryan.
I don't think he was that big.
Oh, I missed him again. Did you miss him again?
Yeah.
He might be going down.
He wasn't big. Otherwise, I would have had him.
And this is definitely cobia territory here. Cobia sailfish. There he is.
You got him, Rick?
No. No, this guy's annoying me. Once he leaves, he's gonna leave here in a little bit. I think. I hope. Still marking. He's the last of the incoming right now. Now, Russ, you can move that cooler to the. I know that, but move that cooler to the starboard side of the boat. On, Johnny?
Yeah, I got
him. Hooked up, baby! First fish on the first fish on that rod and reel, huh?
Yeah.
One thing I want to talk to you guys about is this descending tool that Rick introduced me to. And according to Fish Rules app, this tool is required in the South Atlantic and federal waters. So if you're going out grouper or snapper fishing, you have to have this tool. And not only do you have to have it ready to go. So in other words, you have to have over 60 feet of line on a reel with, I think, 16 ounces of weight already secured to the tool, ready to go. And it's an interesting tool because what happens is, I don't know if you've ever vented a fish in the past and the fish didn't make it. If you have, hit the like button for me. I've had it happen to me in the past where I've you know, vented the fish as best as I know how to do. You could hear the air come out and everything. You push them, you push the air out of them, and then you send the fish down and he doesn't make it. And it's disappointing. So what this tool does is it actually hooks into the lip of the fish, has a weight on it, and it brings the fish down.
It's another method to to release the fish. So we're gonna get the reel, put it on the rod holder, back off the drag a little bit. We're gonna get the fish. We're gonna insert this on the bottom lip. So it comes out this way. And basically now, the weight's gonna go down and the weight's gonna bring the fish nose down into the depths. You ready? Here we go.
And once you've got it down, then you just set on this tool and it releases the fish and the fish is good to go.
A braid?
Right.
I'm coming here and you see how clean it cuts it.
Yep.
So there's that little nugget isn't sticking up. And I put some of this glue on it. You just gotta put it in the shade.
Okay.
And then cure it, and when it hits the sun, it immediately dries in like 1 second. You just can't let the sun hit it when you do it. And at night, if you do it, you need a little UV light. But I'll turn in the shade and put it on the top of the knot and the bottom, like so, to protect the ends. So when it ramps through the guides, it protects it from chafe. And then when you turn to the sun, it'll cure right now in just a split second.
That's it, you're done.
Well, now it has kind of a protective coating on it. And you see that ramp here, when it hits the guides, is real smooth. And the ramp there is real smooth. And from hitting the guides, it won't chafe because it has that little glue on it. It's kind of a thicker glue, you know?
Yeah.
You can see like on my finger, it dries in little hard clumps the second it hits the sun. You ever use it?
No, no.
Give me your finger, watch. So, it's in liquid form. Put your finger in the sun.
Oh wow, it got hot quick.
It gets hot fast. Now give it like 10 seconds. And now touch it and it's hard.
Yeah, oh wow.
And you can peel it off now.
Oh wow.
So instead of being super glue that breaks,
oh wow, it's got a little, pliable? It's pliable.
This is pliable?
Yeah.
So it doesn't break and crack and it keeps the, this is only 10 pound braid, so when it's going through those guides, it just has that little shell on it to protect it.
Brick the Piva, thank you for taking me out fishing. Russ, it was great fishing with you, man. Guys, if you're interested, I'm gonna put a link below for Russ if you wanna run a charter with him and go out fishing with Russ. He's a great captain, he's a great fisherman, he's a great guy. He's a guy that I would trust out on the water. But don't forget to like and subscribe. You could also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Jig On.